Hello there folks, welcome to the Tech Prattle, and today we are looking at Google Pixel 5. Google released Pixel 4a and 5G just a couple of weeks back, Pixel 5 being the latest and the greatest from Google in the Pixel series for 2020. The phone comes in a box like this, which is a rather small box compared to some of the other phones in the market. So when you open up the box, the first thing you see is the phone. Further down you have the 18 watt charger, along with the USB-C charging cable. The point to note here is that the cable is USB-C on both ends, which is good because you don't have to remember which end goes where. That's always handy. And you also get this dongle, which is a USB-A to USB-C. Apart from that, the box doesn't have anything else. It's a comparatively simple unboxing experience. So we'll be going through the main features of this phone, both hardware and software wise. But let's set our reference point first. Phone can be had for around $699 US or £599. Then again, if you pre-ordered the phone, you probably got an extra gift from the Google as part of your order. Here in my region, Google was offering the Bose QC35-2 headsets, which are Bose's noise cancelling headsets, and if you want to buy that headset on its own, you will probably pay around 150 to 200 bucks, and if you want to sell it off anyway, you will probably be getting around 100 quid for that. The real cost of the phone then is £499 or $599 US. So with that said, at that price point, there are certainly phones out there which will give you a Snapdragon 8 series chipset. So if your phone is your daily driver for playing games or running any other high performance applications, then probably this phone is not for you. This phone has the 765G chipset in it. It has 8 gigs of RAM and comes with 128 gigs of storage. The storage is UFS 2.1, so that's not the latest and the greatest. It's I think one generation older than what you can get in some of the other phones. Front of the phone is Gorilla Glass 6. It's entirely covered by that. There are no speaker grills on the front. As you can see, there's a small pinhole camera to the left hand side on the top. I think it's a nice choice because it minimizes the distraction, especially if you have it horizontally and you're watching a video. The pinhole comes to your left bottom, so it's almost outside your main viewing area. On the right hand side, you have the power button, which has a nice accent to it. So if you're getting sage green, you will get this nice glossy green color on the power button, and it is followed by the volume up and down button. On the other side of the phone, there's nothing except the SIM slot. Now this is just a single SIM slot. At the bottom of the phone, you have two ports for the speaker, and then you have the USB-C charger slot, and at the top you don't have much going on there. At the back of the phone, the first thing you notice is the square black area which houses the two cameras for this phone. On the left hand side is a 12 megapixel camera, which is the main shooter, and on the right hand side you have the ultra wide 16 megapixel lens here. On the top of the camera you have a flash. The camera section is followed by the fingerprint sensor here. I like the fact that the sensor has the same color as the body. So I have a Google logo towards the bottom here. So the overall feel and the build of the phone is quite nice. It's quite solid. So the build is metal. Having said that, there is almost like a rubbery or a plastic coating going on the top of the metal build itself, so you don't feel the metal, so you don't have a metal feel in your hand when you're holding the phone as such. For people like me who have small hands, this is quite nice. Phone can be a bit more slippery than I would have liked, so that's one thing I don't like about the finish they have here on the back or the sides of the phone. I'm basically nitpicking here because none of that will be an issue if you're not one of those who like to go commando and always slaps a case on top of the phone, which I'll probably end up doing. So let me put my Redmi Note 9 Pro here and also stick in the LG V30 in the middle for a quick comparison of the size of this phone. One thing you should notice is the LG V30 has a 6-inch screen, and this phone has a 6-inch screen as well. It is much smaller, has a much smaller and thinner profile than even LG V30. One of the factors which is contributing to this sleekness of this phone are the bezels. Bezels on the side and on top and the bottom are very small. very slim, brings the size of the phone down by that much. Let's get into the phone. The fingerprint scanner is the way to go on this phone. Google has done away with the facial recognition system they had in their previous generation Pixels. It's a much better way of logging into your phone. In these COVID infested world, half the time you will be wearing masks out and about anyway. It's good to see the fingerprint scanner make a comeback here on Pixels. Screen is a OLED panel. It is a 90 hertz panel, so Google hasn't upped the frequency of the screen itself, which is not a bad thing. You will definitely notice is the difference in the smoothness on the screen between a 60 hertz panel and a 90 hertz panel. It is also HDR 10 plus certified. If you want to tinker with the settings, you can further go into the display and select between different color options. So at the moment I have set it to adaptive, but if you are after a more natural look, you can select that option, or you can permanently boost it by selecting the boosted option here. Also to note is that this phone does not have a headphone jack. Also, the phone doesn't have an option to take a SD card, so no SD cards and no headphone jack on this phone. The phone comes with Pixel Launcher. I think this is one of the best, if not the best launcher out there in the market, but again that depends on how much of a customization freak you are. So if you swipe up, it will take you to the app drawer, and if you swipe down, a single swipe will give you 6 toggles, and further swipe will give you all the 6 toggles again, but much more spaced out. And this is one of the things which I don't like. I think they could have easily fit another row of the toggle buttons, and maybe 2. So instead of just displaying 6 toggle buttons, they could have easily displayed 9, or at least give us an option in the launcher settings to display more toggle buttons if you want to. The phone out of the box will not display the battery percentage. For that, you have to go into the settings for the battery and switch this toggle on to display the battery percentage. Not a big deal, but again, one of those things which I would have liked to be selected by default. The phone can now record a history of the notifications. There have been many times, and you will be lying if you say no, where you swipe away a notification only to realize that that might be quite important. You can go to this setting on this phone to turn on the notification history. This is not turned on by default, so this is something you have to turn on by going into this menu. Once you turn it on, you will see the phone will then maintain a record of your notification. So even if you swipe it away, you can come to this menu here and have a look at all your notifications. At the moment, I understand that this is a Pixel only feature. You can also swipe down on the fingerprint scanner to see your notifications. Again, that's a feature you need to specifically go and enable it in the settings of this phone. If you go to this launcher option, you can now select different styles as well, different icon styles for the toggles in your notification panel. You can also select different accent colors for the toggles as well. Other things they have added is now Google Assistant can keep the place for you if you are on hold. One of the other things they have added is the call screening feature, which allows Google to interact with your caller. It gives you the transcript of the call on the screen and you can take over anytime you want. So obviously I'd like to try this feature out, but it's mostly my wife who calls me nowadays, and I don't think she will appreciate me trying this out with her. Battery wise, the phone has a capacity of 4080 milliamp hours. For such a small form factor, it is an impressive amount of battery they have put into this phone. Phone can easily last a day. So far the battery performance has been quite good. So let's dig into the camera now. Pixel phones are quite famous for their cameras, but you should note that the lens has not changed from the last generations. What you do have in addition is the ultra wide lens this time. Camera interface is nice and smooth. You'll have an option to select 2x zoom, no zoom, which is 1x, and 0.6x, which is the ultra wide lens. Also have other options like the night mode and the portrait. You can adjust the blur in your picture, and normally the results are obviously not as sharp as actually having the portrait effect when you take the picture, but it's still not bad. I would say it's 70% there. The other option I do like is the portrait light. So scenarios where you're trying to take a picture of yourself or a group of friends, but you have a bright background behind you, this allows you to make the foreground or the subject of the photo a bit more lighter, so you can move it around to change the angle of the focus as well.
See, the video quality is so much better. the focusing is on point as I transition, especially here.
Performance on this phone is quite good, as you would expect for 765G chipset. Phone plays most of the games, I think I would say around 99% of the games without any problems. With all that said, this phone is not without its compromises, but it depends on what your priorities are. So for example, you don't have a headphone jack. In the past, phone without a headphone jack would have been a no-go for me, but given that we are not commuting as much as we used to do pre-COVID, most of the work is from home, you will probably end up using your computer to listen to your music. So I think the importance of the phone as a music player kind of diminishes a bit. The other thing you don't have is SD card expansion slot. This phone comes with 128 gigs of storage. Now for some it might be enough, but for others like me, I will most definitely end up going over that during its life cycle. So I quite like this phone. It has basically everything I would like to have in this COVID invested world, and that has surprisingly changed some of my priorities as well, as I discussed. Overall, I would definitely recommend this phone, especially if you're not looking out for the best chipset and the best performance all the time. Then definitely give this a thought and consider this as one of your options. So right, that's my take on Pixel 5. I will have another video shortly with a full camera comparison between Pixel 5 and S20. But in the meanwhile, I hope you liked this video. If you did, please click the like button and subscribe. And I will see you in the next one. Cheers.